All right, guys, we made it. Week one of quarantine, out of the way. We've been locked down for 1 week. Everyone's still here. It's all good. We can crack on. All right. So we've got week one of lockdown out of the way, and I did start this week off by doing a couple of live videos on YouTube and Facebook, and while those kind of went down pretty well, I felt like I rambled on a little bit more because I'm so used to doing these videos and then editing them afterwards that I kind of didn't take into consideration the fact that I wouldn't be editing them afterwards, so I kind of went on for a little bit. But basically what I went into on those videos is some things about how to kind of keep yourself going, motivated during a lockdown situation such as this, and just some things that you can do to kind of keep your brain and your body in an okay position. So to kind of recap what I said in those videos, I basically kind of said that this is a very weird position that we've found ourselves in now, particularly for people of a similar generation to myself, in so much as that we don't really kind of know how to navigate this area. Like, we're not used to kind of having everything closed down to us and, you know, being really strict on where we can and can't go at certain times and everything. But all I basically said in these videos was essentially to take into consideration what you are in control of and what you're not in control of. And that will definitely help you kind of keep a certain amount of perspective on your situation. Like, what you're not in control of is other people doing what they're supposed to be doing. What you're not in control of is how quickly this is getting sorted. What you're not in control of is how long this is going to last. So the best thing to do is focus on the things that you are in control of. And things you are in control of is distancing yourself from social media sometimes. You don't constantly need to be seeing everything on social media that other people are or are not doing. Focusing on the people around you, making sure the people around you are safe and healthy and occupied, everything like that. That's definitely a very important thing to remember to do. Switching off the news every so often is another thing that you are in control of. Yes, it is obviously really good to kind of keep a track of how things are going at a time like this, and, you know, progress and everything like that. But having the news going all the time is really not going to help you. It's just going to make you feel worse about how things are. So switch it off every so often. Keeping yourself in a routine really does help. That's what I've been doing this week. You know, I'm not just kind of rolling out of bed, putting on some comfy clothes, and then being complicit for the rest of the day. No, no, no. Make sure that you kind of, you know, you want to get up. You want to shower every day at a regular time that you might do. Gives you that sense of, you know, weeks and days being separated from one another. For God's sake, do put on pants. Seriously, I mean, that's important. But on the flip side of that, wear slippers. I am a big endorser of wearing slippers at all times at this point. Like, yeah, the rest of you can be in regular clothes, but I'll be damned if my feet are going to be in something uncomfortable, okay? And if you're working from home, absolutely fantastic. I take my hat off to you. Well done on doing that. If you are not working from home, do find things to occupy your days with. Me personally, I have been doing so much DIY this week. Oh my God. Like, honestly, all of these things that I would go around the house every day and go, oh yeah, I've got to put that up, or I've got to fix that, or I've got to stick this onto the wall, or I want to find somewhere for this to go. We've literally done that this week, and it's been great. So what I've found is that having certain things to do, or cross off a list, or get out of the way, or, you know, a skill that you want to pick up, or something you want to learn, or anything like that, that gives you that sense of achievement that you get out of that day that you would otherwise usually get from coming home from a day from work. Having that thing to do during the day to get out of the way or take part in or something like that, by the time that you are done with that at the end of the day, you feel like not only do you deserve that kind of wind down time, you find it easier to switch off. If you're switched off, entirely through the day, you're going to find it that much harder to switch on when you're going to need it. So my advice is absolutely find things to do with your day. Keep yourself occupied by whatever means. It doesn't necessarily need to be creative or DIY or anything like that. Just do things that you've been wanting to do or get out of the way or been meaning to do for a while and do them. And then you'll feel that kind of sense of achievement and that weight kind of lifted off your shoulders a little bit, and you'll be able to sit down and go, do you know what? I've done that now. I feel so much better. I've earned this relaxing time in the evening. You'll find it so much easier to switch off by that point. It is important to keep your brain and your body active at times like this. So, you know, if you're used to exercising kind of regularly like I am, you are going to find it difficult after a while if you cannot go to the gym. I know I am. So I am looking for other outlets of that. If any of you have any decent suggestions for things to do or places to go, figuratively, not literally, I meant like online places, or even just like regular things that you can kind of do to keep up what your regular workout might be, absolutely, we are open to all kinds of suggestions here. So what you can expect from me, obviously, I know I usually do film reviews. I am going to be doing some more of those. I might go back and do some retrospective ones from ones that I've missed as and when they come out. There are some films that are being released on demand on their actual release date that they would have in cinemas, but they're releasing them at home on demand. So I'll be watching those as well and doing reviews of those. I do have some other travel vlog videos that I need to get through that will hopefully be finished and going up very soon. And I also intend to do some other little projects to keep myself occupied. Such is the problem of being an ADD riddled child growing into an adult. I have to find things to do because otherwise I will just burn a hole in the wall staring at it. So for people like me that find it hard to not be doing things, I am looking for things to do. But please, we do welcome any and all comments on this channel. So tell us, what have you been doing to keep yourselves occupied during this tumultuous time? How are you finding things? What are you doing to keep yourself occupied? Are you all right for pasta and toilet roll? So all comments are welcome in the comment section below. Let's talk lockdown. Now, I did think it would be kind of good to keep people's brains active by doing like a weekly brain teaser or something, like a riddle, like a puzzle kind of thing. And I put it out on Facebook and I don't think a whole lot of people saw that part. So I will leave one here for you. So this is one of my favorite ones. It's a relatively simple answer. So it's a deceptively simple one, this one. Do think about it though. So there is a physicist, an engineer, and a mathematician, and a farmer asks them to build the most efficient fence that they can. Now the physicist builds a square fence, claiming that it will close in the most square meter area for the fence that he has. The engineer builds one really long fence and says that the end could be infinite and that fencing half of the world would be the most efficient use of the fencing that you have. And then the mathematician scoffs and proceeds to build the most efficient fence out of all three of them, but what did he build? So if you think you know the answer to that one, you can put that in the comments section below and we will see if you are right. As always, if you have enjoyed what you've seen here and you do want to see more, and you got some suggestions for what you'd like to see from these particular kinds of videos in the future, you can click right here to subscribe and see some more funky fresh videos from yours truly. And until that point, look after each other, stay safe. For God's sake, stay at home, wash your hands, and for the love of God, put on some pants. I see you. Yeah, you. Right there. You. Put some pants on.